Hi guys, and welcome back to Formula 1 2015. It's been so long since I last made a video of this game and also played it in my own time. I've just been very occupied with the new games that have come out, such as Metal Gear and Fallout 4. I've just been having too much fun on them, and I haven't really been making any of the videos besides Fallout 4. So in today's video, I'm glad to actually start making or continue with the other series of the games that I left off with, which includes Metal Gear, F1 2015, Fallout 4, maybe The Walking Dead, and other games in the future. But today's video, we are going to be racing on the Japanese Grand Prix. And as you can see on the leaderboard, Nico Rosberg, who I play as, is at the top, followed by Lewis Hamilton, who's second, and Sebastian Vettel, who's third. Now, I've left the settings exactly how they were. I haven't changed anything at all. The only thing that's different from the previous videos is that they've updated the game quite substantially in terms of optimization to make the game more smooth. They fixed a lot of bugs and glitches, and they've also added a few graphical improvements to the game as well, which will be interested to see how different it looks. But without further ado, guys, let's race.
Welcome to Suzuka in Japan, where today's practice session is about to begin on this figure of eight circuit. The Suzuka track never disappoints, and that's probably why it's so loved by drivers and fans alike. As we approach the end of the season, the teams will be keeping a close eye on the constructors' table. Every point the drivers can get is really important for the teams at this stage.
Yes, definitely. Every position you climb in the championship has a financial gain come the end of the season. So the difference between finishing third or fourth is well worth fighting for right up until the last race.
You at the top of the table. You're 3/10 down. Lewis is currently P2. There's 2 minutes remaining.
That's the end of practice, and it's Lewis Hamilton who was able to achieve the fastest time on the track today. Go, and that's what the cars will be doing shortly here in Japan as they take to the track for today's Japanese Grand Prix qualifying session. I'm expecting a strong showing here today from the Red Bull team. They really love this classic track and have had so much success at Suzuka over the years.
I think this could be a showdown between the Mercedes and Red Bulls today. The Red Bull team have enjoyed incredible success here over the years, but the Mercedes package could be too much for the Milton Keynes based team.
So, as you can see during the practice session just then, I was just getting used to the track. Again, I haven't played this for a very long time, as you can tell, and this is probably my least favourite track out of all of them, really. I don't really like it at all. I find it difficult to race on this track, but I guess that adds to the excitement. So we'll see what the qualifying does for us, and we'll take it from there.
Session has been for Mercedes today. They've locked the front row of the grid for tomorrow's race.
They've really worked hard this weekend, and it seems they've been able to set up the cars perfectly today. Whether this will translate into race pace tomorrow, well, we'll just have to wait and see.
We're at the classic and much-loved Suzuka circuit for today's race. This fabulous track has been the scene of some of Formula One's greatest Grand Prix, and we're hoping today is going to be another one of them. We knew this was a track that suited the Mercedes well, but no one would have expected that Lewis Hamilton would have created such a gap to his rivals in qualifying. If he stays out of trouble and the car continues to perform, well, victory should surely be a formality.
He'll want to stay out of trouble over the first few laps, but he'll be determined not to let any cars past him. If he can maintain that position once everything's settled down, he'll have a massive advantage and be able to control the race.
How does Nico Rosberg go about finding the time he was lacking at the end of qualifying in today's race?
Well, he's got to stay within touching distance of the lead during the first stint and then look to capitalise as the car becomes lighter and the tyre degradation eases.
So as you can see from the qualifying results, we are starting second, which isn't particularly bad because we get the inside line. Unfortunately, during down the fast straight on the left-hand corner, we cut the corner a bit, which slowed us down. We almost got first position, quite a few lockups, but other than that, kind of getting used to the track. So again, let's see what happens at the end of the race. So I hope you guys enjoy, and yeah.
You have a great chance of taking home the win today. Let's make this work for us. as it should remain dry. We will keep you informed of any changes to the weather. miles worth of spare fuel in the car. You won't be able to run in Mix 3 for long with that much, but do burn it if you need to. Right, we expect these tyres to be good for a while yet. Just be careful with them in the high-speed corners. 1 second of the car ahead. Get ready to use DRS to overtake. seconds adrift at Bottas.
It's a win for Mercedes and a win for Lewis Hamilton. The British driver was the class of the field today and fully deserves his victory.
Ultimately, it's all about whoever reaches the checkered flag first, and today was his day.
Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling instalment of this Formula One season.
So the good news in that is we got bronze, we came third in that race. Unfortunately, in my opinion and probably in your opinion, I didn't really deserve that. One, because I caused a minor accident, well, I won't call it minor, I called it an incident on the second lap around. I think I hit the back end of Sebastian Vettel, and in theory it should have taken us both out because the impact was hard enough to cause quite substantial damage to both our cars. I'm surprised that I didn't get any penalties for that. The fourth time around, Sebastian Vettel, I believe it was Sebastian Vettel, overtook me just after the high speed straight as it turns left. He tried overtaking on the inside, and I think again my mistake, I instead of just slowing down and allowing him space to overtake me, I clipped his back right tire and caused a huge incident with three other cars, I believe. It also damaged my front wing. I believed it damaged his car as well, so luckily the pits was nearby. I had to go off into the runoff area because I didn't want to cause any more collision, because with me not having a front wing, I don't have full control over the car. So I had no choice but to come into the pits and use the runoff area to, you know, get there safely. After the fourth or fifth lap, it went real, real smoothly. I was pretty impressed with how I was racing. Had a bit of a fight with Kimi Räikkönen. I think it was for fourth place, and then we were behind Bottas. But I think Bottas went into the pits at the last lap, allowing us to take third place, because I was sure that we were only going to finish fourth, but we managed to finish third. So I'm not sure why he went into the pits. The last five or four laps of that race were very difficult because Because I came into the pits early, because of the incident that I caused, I changed my tyres to the prime tyres, the harder tyres. And even though they last longer than the soft tyres, it didn't really last through to the whole race. Not really. There were a lot of sliding. I couldn't get a grip on turning corners. And braking was a little bit of an issue. I had to brake a lot earlier round corners than I had if I had fresh tyres on. But again, guys, I have just started this game again. I think it was three or four weeks ago since I put a video on of F1 2015. Hope you guys can forgive me on this race. But yeah. So, just like to thank you guys for watching this video. Take care, and I will see you in the next video. Bye, guys.